bird on a tree. I'm just sitting here.
Hi guys, in today's video we are going to cover about the first step of Canada PR process, which is ECA. We will tell you various mistakes to avoid, some important notes and other FAQs. So stay tuned.
ECA stands for Educational Credential Assessment. But what does it do? It is used to verify that your foreign degree, diploma or certificate is valid and equal to a Canadian degree or not. There are different types of ECAs. In this video, we are going to talk about ECA for immigration purposes. Next question is, which credentials or which degree you need to get assessed? In most of the cases, you only need an assessment for your highest level of education. For example, if you have a master's degree, you only need an assessment for that. Well, now the last question, who can do your assessment? So there are certain designated organizations which are meant for this purpose. They will generate a report and tell you the equivalency to a Canadian education. So there are certain designated organizations which can do your assessment. Namely WES, which is World Education Services. We are going to walk through about this process. International Credential Assessment Service of Canada, which is ICAS. International Qualification Assessment Service, which is IQS. International Credential Evaluation Services, ICS. Comparative Education Service, which is the University of Toronto. All these organizations charge more or less same kind of fee, but the processing time is different. In case of WES, it has the least processing time. So we have opted for this. So now let's get started with the step-by-step process of WES application. Here you can see we have landed to the WES website. You can find the link from the description. And one important thing you can see here that COVID update is present on the notice board, where it says that they are still operational and business is still continued. So you can start applying for your application. So there is a quick look with simple steps of the evaluation process. The step 1 says that you need to submit your application for evaluation. Step 2 says that all the required documents you need to send or your university needs to send to WES. And step 3, which is the final step, says that you need to send the documents and all of them will be verified by WES. Apply now icon, which will process and will show you another page which will ask you for which country you need to do the evaluation. For our case, this is Canada, so we'll select Canada. So here you can see we need to select the application type. There are different application types present over here. First one is the WES standard application, which is for the education purposes. Second one is for the application for IRCC, which is basically for immigration purpose. You can see you can select the ECA. So let me first brief you about different steps coming over. So let's enter the first name, last name, date of birth, all other mandatory information which is required by the WES application. Enter a valid email ID and create a password for that. Now there is an option to select a security question. Select any question and provide the answer to it. If you want, you can subscribe to the newsletter and finally create an account. Now you can see all the enter details are present over this page. Now you have to enter your mailing address, select an address where you want WES to send all your personal correspondence relating to your application. Provide a valid phone number. Now here you can see your login information which is given. Click on next. Here you can see there is a note provided stating few of the important points. Let me just brief you. First point states that individuals must complete a separate WS application. Like in case of a couple applying for the immigration process, both husband and wife needs to create a separate WS account for the evaluation. Also, you need to register only your completed degrees for evaluation done by for the IRCC application. Now let's add a credential, whatever is the highest level of education or degree or diploma you have. Select bachelor's program or master's degree, whatever is the underlying option. Now you have to enter the name of the institution. So for this field, we were also doubtful that whether we have to enter our college name or university name or what. So the answer is you have to enter the name of the university from which you have graduated. Now again enter your name and other details which are present on the degree of certificate present. For an example, I have already added one credential for a bachelor's degree. You can go on further and add your master's or doctoral, what all option is there for you. Now in the final review, you need to enter your personal address as a recipient one. And as a recipient two, WS will be directly sending your application for approval to the IRCC. Now you can see that in the final review, it is stating that the processing time is of about 35 business days. So when you scroll down, you can see a total amount of $220 Canadian dollars is applicable for evaluation through WS and opt for the standard delivery or a international courier tracking option. In this case, I am just opting for the standard mail via Canada Post. Also to IRCC, it will send the report of evaluation to IRCC directly. Now here you can see the list of required documents. There is kind of a checklist provided. You need to submit all the documents and send it to WS for the evaluation. The first one is your degree certificate that you can upload a clear and legible copy in the My Account section. Now comes the most important part is the official transcripts. You have to ask your institution, your university, which is responsible for conducting the examinations, to send your documents directly to WS in a sealed envelope, and it should not be tempered. Also, WS will not accept any documents which are sent by the students themselves or any third party agents. In that case, it will be rejected. Now you can see an important information is there that WS only accepts documents issued and attested by designated officials of your institution. It should not be sent by any of the professors or any external notary publics. Also, if you have completed less than 1 year of your full-time post-secondary academic study, then it is recommended to send your secondary school documents also. You can also refer, if you have any queries, to the frequently asked questions here. Now comes the another most important section of sending your documents, how you should send the documents, in what format. So first of all, after completing your application, you will receive a WES reference number which should be present on the top of the courier delivery. Do not send your original documents, only the copies of all your documents. Now it's time to review all your personal information for the last time and go for the payment page. just mark all the check boxes and have a look to the documents required by WS. Check all the terms and conditions in hand and clicks on next. Now for the payment section, you need to select the payment type. You can select any of the payment types, any method. Enter your payment details and finally click on submit. After the submission of your application, you will receive a WS reference number. Just keep it for your future purpose and you are done with this.